deeper than music.
The core of you, the fans, the truth is deeper than music. Deeper than music. Simply the truth is the latest, the newest. It's deeper than music. Deeper than music. The core of you. The fans, the truth.
What up? This is your man Furious, Deeper Than Music Radio Show. How's everybody out there doing in internet land? Right now, I hope you got your books. I hope you got your notebooks. We got somebody from the DFW area that's been putting it down. One of the founders here of the founder. One of the few guys that network and actually give knowledge out here. My man, Mr. Lewis Gray is in the building. T-Rex is in the building here on Deeper Than Music Radio.
Pleasure. Thank y'all for having me, bro. I'm truly honored to be here.
No problem, man. Thanks for coming out, fam. And one thing I want to say is I'm an implant from the D.C. area, originally from San Antonio, but when I first came to this area, I was checking out the scene, and there was a few people that came out and reached out to me and gave me some insight on the DFW hip-hop scene, and my man T-Rex, and this was before Deeper Than Music, this was before I even let it be known I do music, my man Lewis Gray came out and definitely one of the few guys that shared knowledge with me, and I'm very appreciative of that, brother.
Word, man. I mean, hey, man, look, I'm here, you know what I'm saying? I'm blessed to be here, and anything that I do for any of these brothers or these sisters out here, nobody really gave me that, so I know it's protocol for me. It's not me critiquing anybody's crap, but it's definitely.
Hey man, and that's what we need more in here. It's all about building a network. So I guess the first question for my peeps that aren't in the DFW area or in the internet or in Germany, Denmark, you know, where many of our listeners are.
Peace.
Who is Lewis Gray, man? Who are you? What do you represent? What do you bring to the game?
Man, truth. The first thing, man. I'm a pure artist. When I say pure, I can't be tainted. Everybody else done wrote a how-to handbook of what the hell not to do. So what I do is see that. When I see that, I know what not to do. So doing me is very easy to do this, you know, as far as being free to write and create. So Lewis is a guy that done had a struggle. You know, my story is truly real. You know, you hear these guys, and no disrespect to them, you know, but the story is somewhat still the same. No, I'm not first of all, Lewis is not a thug.
Okay.
Lewis tried that.
Okay.
I did not succeed. Lewis is not a drug dealer. I'm not a trapper. Hence the word trap. Think about that and marinate.
Oh, wow. So, I didn't even think about that. Yeah, that's deep right there.
You're saying you need to really marinate. I don't knock anybody what they do or whatever they was resulted to feel like they had. Me, I don't follow none of that. I follow me. You know, and whatever the path is laid out for me that God set forth for me to do, that's what I do. Doing anyone else, he would never do.
So basically what you're saying, and when you bring up a good point, like right now, and I post this on Facebook, I'm like, with hip-hop, can we please... The three requirements. Can we please not talk about how we've lost? Can we please not talk about the X-rated exploits we did with women? And can we not please talk about how our crew was, you know, me rap? Because, like, the other day I was listening to the radio. I'm like, man, it sounds like one rerun, one after the other, after the other, after the other. And then, matter of fact, I had one dude try to sell me his CD. I listened to the CD, and I'm like, yo, okay, you got skills, but can you tell me your story? So I'm glad you say that. You know what I mean? Everybody got the cookie cutter.
Yeah,
but
man.
Yeah, what's up with your story? So, what is your style, man? You say truth. How is it? Is it a boom bap? Or how do we deliver that message?
Definitely, I follow the gold school technique in here.
Okay.
With a now sense of where it is and needs to be. It's really timeless. It all depends on the producer. I produce music. But I don't physically click or beat anything. I do is set the concept in front of the producer. Right now, that producer happened to be Timothy Big Hub Webb.
Okay,
you know
okay. Shout out
to Bundy Souls Music. Yeah, shout out to my man Tim Big Hub. Same guy that produces Darren Tech Force Commanders. He does several other artists around him. But that guy understands it. Meaning that if I set a concept in front of him, I'm just showing you who I am.
Yeah.
Here's how I feel about certain things. I wrote a song, it was called Focus. He gave me the most orchestrated music to make you feel like your ass was watching some kind of presentation of the big ass.
Oh, it's like big cinematic.
Man, but it was some moving shit. It's making your skin crawl, bro. But that's how I like to set up who I am. I have to tell the story.
Okay.
So when I say following the gold school era or following the gold school traits, these cats told stories. They told the truth. They told you, they gave you basic structure of what it is you need to do with hip hop.
Yeah.
Before it got tainted. Before it got jacked up. Some of these cats still follow that, and those cats, they may be famous, but not on those heights.
Yeah, and I'm glad you say that too, because people assume that a producer is, like you say, click. But like what people don't know, like with Dr. Dre has, he has people on call. Like he may have a Horman on call, he got this person on call.
Deck.
And then he's like, once he got an idea, he got a beat laid out, boom, here you come, I want you to do this, 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 this. And like you say, he lays the foundation. Yeah. So that's also a producer. And then another great, Michael Jackson. Michael Jackson, I mean, he worked with great people.
Boy.
He would also look, this is what I want, this is how I wanted to sound. And if you guys ever get a chance to listen to Michael's demos, how he beatboxing and all this and that,
I see what
you're saying.
Yes,
so that's another way. You bring people, you bring the talent, like this is my vision and this is where I want to go.
Yeah.
So I got a question. When did you know you wanted to be involved in music? Or when did you know that you wanted to be an MC? Do you remember that moment?
Like, I do. I remember it like it was yesterday. I was living in Hutchinson, Kansas. I was staying with my uncle, going to Hutchinson. And used to run trucks for Dillon's Warehouse.
Okay.
And every Friday, I would go to the mall. At this time, Elf was out acting.
Oh, at King Z. Okay.
So I'm going to go get a lot of this stuff, you know what I'm saying? DJ Quick's the name, shit like that.
DJ Quick. Golden Era.
Real dope ass music.
Yeah, 90s.
So all of this stuff was out in Fear of Black Planet, PE. Yeah, shit like this. So I'm coming in with Horse and CD.
Okay.
My Uncle Otis is looking at me, God rest his soul. He's looking at me. Why are you spending all your money on? Why are you doing? He said, what are you listening to? So we sat down. Ooh. We sat down. Listen to me. Like, listen to me. Oh, business as usual.
EPMD. Oh, EPMD. Oh, my God. That's the foundation right there.
So my uncle Otis is like, okay, you got a good taste in hip hop. He said, I didn't even know anything about these groups. And I really like their music. I said, well, Uncle Otis, I just like their shit. LL shit came out too. Like, Mama said, knock you out. It just came out. All of this shit was going on. To make my point, Uncle Otis went to Dollar General. He got three fucking notebooks and a lot of big round sticks that came in a pack.
Okay.
He sat down and he told me this. Tony, you have been through more shit than anybody I know in my name. And then incarcerated. So much stuff. When my uncle sent me, I was over in South Dallas, straight fresh from the week. After 6 months.
Oh, wow.
Not by my own. I came out here on the front. Somebody put up money for me to come out here so I wouldn't be out in Louisiana anymore. I didn't want to be there.
Yeah.
My mom was already out here being very successful. But I was being very fucking hard-headed. Yeah. She loved me to death, but yeah, my little sister to take care of.
Okay, that's
and I was being real hard-headed and under it, thinking I knew shit and I didn't know anything. My uncle saved my life. He sent for me.
Okay.
I came out there. He gave me a sense of self and some direction.
He
told me who I was, let me know that I am important. But he also let me know I had a story to tell.
Exactly.
Won't you write it down, Tony? He said, play with the words. He said, I don't know what it is to do with what it is that you do, or how you gonna do it. He said, I know you like beats. He said, find some, do they have the music without the lyrics on it. Right to some of that.
Instrumentals, yeah.
So now I'm in another world. Sit down, I listen. I let them listen to the first rap I wrote, and I trust me, it sounded like some shit over there off of 157, the landfill over there in that big ass hill. That shit was garbage. It was garbage. He laughed his ass off. He did. He said, look, keep trying.
Yeah, keep trying. Nurture that craft and keep doing
it. I nurtured it. My uncle is the reason why I wasn't even, I was a fan of it.
Yeah.
All of these, this is what I was listening to. This is what, that's the first record classic. I bought. The Run DMC album. That one. I bought that on a cassette.
Which one? King of Rock.
Yeah, King of Rock. Oh, yeah. I live in Louisiana. You know, saying that's the first record I ever bought.
Yeah.
Then Radio by LL Cool J.
Okay.
So, you know, this, I'm a fan. Straight fan. Fat Boys fan. I seen them at Fresh Fest. And
I already knew.
I seen the one when they came to Louisiana.
Fresh Fest.
They came to Louisiana. Yeah, when they came to Louisiana, I seen them. But
80s, man.
Okay,
yes,
so what we gonna do is now that we heard what got you inspired, let's go ahead and spin one of the tracks that we got here. I know. Okay, you mentioned, so we'll go ahead and play Fool. Yeah. And basically, before we play that, can you give us a rundown on this track?
Fools is basically what y'all are bearing witness to now, whether it be Hillary or Donald Trump, whether it be the church, whether it be New Detroit, going down there, blowing up the spot in these churches. Hey, bro, you're dealing with a realist when you're messing with Louis Gray. I have discernment. It's the ability to judge well, not judge people.
Okay.
When you see and you know when it ain't right, oh, it ain't right. These people out here jacked up in these streets, bro, and they looking for direction and leadership. You can't get that when T.D. Jakes and all these people flying all over the damn planet trying to,
how the hell you gonna sit up here
and try to tell me and give me the church when you on CBS and every damn where else? You know what I'm saying? Look here, bro, I'm a realist. Y'all cats out here that say y'all talking that real shit, y'all ain't no shit.
All right, let's go ahead and cue it up. Fool, here we go. Here we go. We dropped it on Deeper Than Music, Louis Gray. Yo, Hop, we need to get a soundbite of a bomb. Drop a bomb on him, baby. That joint. If you was listening, y'all, it reminded me of the golden era. It had so much to say that you gotta go back. You gotta go back and listen. It hit on so many things, and
church.
I'm already knowing. It tapped the nerve. It's gonna make some people feel one way. It's gonna make somebody else feel another way. But brother, you are saying something. You know what I'm saying? You are bringing thought provoking stuff. Like, I'm so tired of,
thank you, bro.
First of all, and because, you know, now, okay, cats want to call me an old head. All right, I'll be that old head. But you know, old heads got knowledge. You know what I'm saying?
The first thing old boy said when I walked in, yeah, I remember you said to mess the mic. Old school head.
Yeah.
Look here, bro. Knowledge transcends. My thing is this. You cast us out here when y'all have the opportunity to have the stage to be in front of the people. With all of this shit that's going on out here in the world, why ain't you talking about it?
Yeah, it's...
I can tell you why you're not talking about it. Because you're part of it.
And let's take it back, like...
Part of the problem, bro.
Why we don't have a self-destruction, are we all in the same gang as we as a collaborative?
Oh,
artists,
man.
As... You know what? I'll throw it out there. I'll throw it out in the universe. Artists, people that are out there right now, people that are listening, I want to challenge you, and I'm going to throw it on my Facebook. Let's get together as a collective. We all in the same game, self-destruction, let's all as a collective, hip-hop, let's talk about what's going on right now. You know what I'm saying? Like, honestly, I have a daughter, but I'd be nervous as hell if I have a son right now,
living in
these times, because, and like you said, if you're not talking about it, then you're part of the problem. I'm tired of seeing, you know what, and I won't even, let's even make it on a broader scale. I'm tired of seeing people in authority figures just disrespecting their rights that they have, or just straight disrespecting the people as a collective. Hip-hop was a voice of the people, for the people. If you take it back broken glass everywhere. It informed you of what's going on.
Church.
When did we stop being informants? My man Louis Gray dropped a bomb on him. You are an informant, man, and I appreciate you for that.
Yeah, no doubt.
So now, because I'm like, wow, man, you just dropped so much, I'm still absorbing it. But to get back to the questions, describe the DFW hip-hop scene and just, I already know what you bring to it. You bring in truth. But since you've been here, since 94 and been an ambassador, to the listeners out in Denmark, Germany, what is the hip-hop scene in the DFW? What is the flavor? What did DFW hip-hop bring to the scene?
A lot of diversity.
Okay.
A lot of diversity. I can honestly say that, bro, because I've had the pleasure of really sharing stages with a lot of these cats out here. A lot of diversity, man. I had the pleasure of sharing the stages with a lot of people out here, a lot of artists. A lot of them great. I could ramble off names and do name drops right now, but you know, we'll be here all day doing that. There is a lot of diversity here in this city right now. Where you would think this city was only noted for one thing. First of all, Houston has been made at least 5 to 6 times.
Yeah.
Dallas has not been that city. Not yet. You know what I'm saying? You would think that right now, you know, shout out to Erykah Badu.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Shout out to her whole entire camp.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Shout out to my man, Juan Bay Cook. You know what I'm saying? My man's been doing major, major things. You know what I'm saying? He got some things on the table right now, too. But here's the thing, man. You know, being that this is our city, you know, you have some people that have been successful and that has actually made it from here. This is our city. Me, I'm looking at it. I'm a realist.
Oh, we know that now. Yeah, I'm truly
a realist. Me, personally, I could not be any of these people in MTV, VH1, BET. I don't give a damn. Viacom would actually come here and actually set up a mother station fucking with me down here. Because you need to know about all of these artists that's going on down here.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
You don't need to know about one select set. You need to know about everything that's diverse out here. I don't give a damn if they was from Pluto and his skin was purple and they was spitting bars of death. If they're good artists.
Oh, yeah.
See, that's another thing that on the cool, this is what I was doing. I see an artist like Terrence Lindsay.
And that's what I wanted to ask. I noticed a lot of cats out here, they give you, I mentioned your name. A lot of people, especially in our community, you embrace them, like you said, like what your uncle did. You feed them confidence. You give them jewels.
You have to.
So let me ask you this.
Yes.
Thank you.
Yes.
Let me ask you this.
Yes, brother. Yes.
When you see an artist, what is it that you look at and like, you know what? That brother's got it. I'm going to feed him. I'm going to feed him the jewels and I'm going to help him proceed. What is it that you look for in art? Or what does the MC have to see for Louis Gray to be like, you want it?
It's not. First of all, it's got to be humility.
Okay.
And we're going to start right there first. I'll give you an example. When I seen T-Lizzy on stage at Lowe's, and I can go through several examples of different artists that I've met.
Yeah.
They have come to me straight humbly. They didn't show they self or any of that crap. And they came to me humbly and they asked, man, I need some help. I see you out here doing what you're doing, bro. You help a lot of people. You know, you give them some kind of whatever. I don't know what it is you do, but it seems to work out for them. You know what I'm saying? I need that kind of help. I need some encouragement or something. When I'm talking to Terrence, I've been telling him, look, man, deliver that shit like nobody's business when you do that shit. Because right now, nobody doing it. You gotta make sure you deliver that shit. With these people in the basement,
yeah,
really slaughter the ass. I'm literally obliterating and buckle their skin. Be aggressive with what you do, but be direct. Now, there's nothing I can really tell you.
Yeah,
that's just
that,
one example.
And then notice, that's I know that's one that brother example. On Facebook, he was like, yo, I'm quitting my job now. This is, I'm doing this full time. He took the bar and ran with it. Shout out to T-Liz.
Yeah, he's a man of business, and that's another thing. That's why I told him. It's 95% of that is 5% of what you love.
Yep, it's called music business.
Yeah, so yes. Now that he understands that, he sees that, you know, people can latch on to him for the wrong reason. Moonwalk away from that shit. Make sure that you are by your lonesome and learning the traits, what it is you want your business to run.
Exactly.
When I ask these guys, ask me to put them on the bigger stage, to see that, your job is to A, brand yourself.
Yep.
Because Lewis is already branded. Yep. I've already been working on my thing. You can't get so immersed up into my shit to where you feel like I'm supposed to be that guy to actually do that for you. No, I'm not him. You're doing that shit for yourself.
Yep, I'm giving you the jewel. And that's the thing,
that's
too.
It.
And that's the thing what people don't understand about this music thing. And this is one thing I had to learn. And this is why one of my things is like, okay, whenever I involve myself in something, I'm going to learn it. Not just because I want to learn it, because I want to make sure you're not doing me dirty. And that way I know, because ignorance is costly. Ignorance is costly.
And it could cost, like, right, for me personally, when I was, these guys, when they came to me, bro, we was on Caravan, from Denton to everywhere, anywhere where it was lit. And I was doing shit, and if I posted, kept seeing 100 motherfuckers in the club, there's 200 motherfuckers. It's lit. So yeah. They want to see that. A bigger stage makes for a broader audience, listeners, to see what it is you truly have.
Yep.
Are you polished with your shit? Just because it's a big audience doesn't mean that you ready.
Exactly.
You get your ass on stage and you'll be like a damn deer in the headlight with all them damn people. You forgetting verses, shit like that. That don't happen all the time. Half of these cats that asked me to get on these stages, they were made ready. I don't care if it was Deuce Straight, Jay Nonstop, Darren Tech Force Columbus. We share stages with a lot of people. A lot of these people are our help. And now they doing exactly what it is that they do. They out here, they running the gauntlet, they doing what it is that they need to do. Me personally, I know what my company is. The group is a songwriting music.
And that's what I wanted to ask you next thing, because you also, besides being an MC, you got your hands in other ventures.
Yes, sir.
First of all, what are they, and how did it evolve from being an MC? Okay, I'm doing this, I'm doing that. I liken it to like my man Puffy. You know, he was the intern. From the intern to boom, Bad Boys to Rock.
There you go.
How did it evolve? How did that brand get evolved?
I went through a lot of things. The first company I had was called Black Works. I released my first album on there, My Life on Paper. I get that shit.
Okay.
When I had Black Works, it was definitely a movement. It was something to where cats, I don't care who it was, Fritz, Osoul, Original Soul, a lot of people. I known Osoul for years, and he knows that I do this.
Go.
I'm moving.
Yeah.
You can be dope as your ass want to be in your house. You can be as, man, I'm no joke.
But you just in the house.
The four walls knows how dope I am. And the walls ain't talking to you, not unless you want some LSD or some shit. You know what I'm saying? The walls are not talking.
You know, remind me of this common verse. Opportunity knock, but he ain't called before.
All right,
you
see? Yeah, see? Yeah.
Exactly.
See? You got to go out and make yourself, man. And anybody that I talk to, this shit is not finna fall in your lap.
Nope.
I'm sorry.
So you saying you went from Black Works
to right now The Group. The Group is a songwriting, music promotion, and production company.
Okay.
It's the right music, the right artist, the right kind of push and promotion. Turn the ear to the listener. And they are actually listening to, hey, great music, great lyrics, a good promotion for you to get into what it is he or she is actually bringing. I don't care if it's R&B. I dabble in writing in R&B. I've dabbled in a lot of hip-hop. I know how to... I'm not the best at doing anything, y'all. I'm just being humble about saying this. You know how to pop off a song and actually get people into the music, not just the actual track, but the actual message in the music and the actual chorus to go to it. I'm not the best that did it, bro, but trust me, I got a catalog of songs that will tell you. And I got a lot of cats out here that will remember right now to date songs, back in the day songs. Right now from my previous albums, I done did side projects. Stella Brothers, that was me and Sky Johnson.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? I got with him and we just hooked up. I seen he was getting a bad shape from a lot of people out here on the scene, on, you know, promoters, what have you not. So me and him just looked up. We linked up. Scott had a lot to deliver to.
So you say you got The Group, so that's also a writing camp. Is there anything else you do?
Right now? produce these records. That's it. I keep it simple. Okay. I know. I'm the backdrop is real, bro. Trust me, the backdrop is
real. So now that we went back to the music, we're going to go ahead and drop another jewel on you. I think you guys are ready now. The dust and clear. So what's that other one we got queued up?
Don't shoot. Oh, man.
Okay, what's the rundown on this joint?
Okay, all right. First of all, shout out to Other Words G-Code. He produced this track for me. Actually gave it to me and said, hey, this is a perfect fit for you. I think you really need to take it. So I did. What I did is went to the hood on this with a lot of knowledge.
Okay.
And I did it in 100 bar segments.
Oh, snap.
So that's what I did. You know what I'm saying? When I do it on stage, cats look for it. They, damn,
all right, so here we go. We about to drop this one on you. Get ready. Another clue bomb for you. Boom! Here on Deeper Than Music Radio with Lewis Gray.
In other words, it's the G code, homie.
Yeah. Lewis Gray is in the building. Two bombs for you.
Yes, sir.
And the last one, Pet Shop Boys, man.
What?
Just keep flip it moving, the Pet Shop Boys, man.
Keep it moving, chick.
Bring it to you. We got, man, my man got diversity. And I even appreciate the fact that you flipped it on the trap, the latest and greatest, and threw some knowledge on them, and you wasn't on that.
Man. Dark Shooter is... That's, put it this way, the title, that was all Other Words. When he gave the track, he named the track that. So I took from the track and actually did that. You know, I'm not a cat that's trying to really, like, shoot you and kill you. But lyrically, I'm trying to tell you something. If I'm going to spit it in 100 bars like that, you about to get some shit. You know what I'm saying? I'm not trying to talk to you in drug terms. We already hear enough of that shit.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? So let the truth be told. I'm not knocking no hustlers or nothing, but even you cats got to switch that shit up.
And it's like this, things have to evolve.
Yeah, bro.
Things have to grow. Let's evolve, let's grow.
Yeah, bro.
Like a concept album. I think the last thing that I heard that was lyrical, like my man Andre 3000 said, let's do something. Let's do time traveling, mind unraveling.
Oh, you know, man, bro.
Let's make it back to art. Let's make it artful, man. I'm tired of, because I feel like I'm just, I get dumb listening to, like, top hip-hop radio stations now. It's like, dang, I think
no
I lost some brain cells.
It's crazy, though.
But you've done a lot, man, and can you share with us some of the highlights in your music career? Like, what are the highlights,
The
man?
Biggest highlight in my music career probably right now is Do It All from the Lords of the Underground coming into town to do a radio interview.
Okay.
With one of the Cowboys. My stuff was playing. The homegirl Princess's car, she's in Atlanta. Shout out to Princess. While she was in a conversation with him, he had asked about the third or fourth song. Who the hell is this? This is commentary from her. So she told him who I was. Can I holler at him? Can I talk to him? So me and Spin, the guy that actually helped me produce that song, the last one that y'all heard, the Pet Shop Boys, shout out to DJ Spin, called me while we was in the studio working on the second project. So she put me on the phone. She said, what's up, Rex? I was like, what's good, Princess? You all right? Said, yeah, I got somebody want to talk to you. I said, okay, put him or her on. Yo, fam, what's good, fam? I was like, yo, what's happening, bro? You all right? He said, yeah. He said, yo, fam, just do it all, dude.
Jersey Chief Rocker.
Yo, but it didn't done on me. Yep. It's not done in yet. It's not really registered yet. That this is Do It All, Dude from the fucking legendary Grammy Award winning Lords of the Underground.
Chief Rocker.
So this fool's, yo, just Do It All, Dude from the Lords of the Underground. You can remember the Sprint commercials with the pin drop?
Yeah.
That's probably the reaction I got. I say, Spin, this is Do It All from Lords on Underground. Spin's like, hey. I say, Spin, this is Do It All from Lords
Underground.
He knew what I was telling. He's like, cool, nigga. This is Do It All. He said, yo, fam, where y'all at? I said, we in the lab. Princess, know where y'all at? I said, yeah, I'm coming over. That fool came to that studio with him and his man. I don't know who the fuck he was, but there was some cool cats, man. It was so cool. Shook my hand, gripped my hand, and told me verbally, up front, I fucks with your flavor, and your bars is impeccable.
Certified right there. You got the stamp right there.
I took a picture with this man, and then we ended up recording something. I don't know if I said
it. Okay. But yeah, we're going to have to get, we're gonna have to get that
joint on. Don't worry, I'm going to bless you. I'm going to bless you. I'm going to make sure y'all stay heated up over my shit. And, but that's one highlight. The other highlight is probably hanging out with T.L. Harris. T.L. Harris is liaison between Biz Beats and T.I. When T.I. wants to be Beats, the guy that actually looks up that. This is the guy that gave me the Golden City when I got in Atlanta. He just signed the Franchise Boys. I just pulled up on the Lean Woody, Rock Woody video shoot, sitting there with Benny Boone. I literally stepped off the plane and walked into the shit. Because I gave him a demo of the group that I was with, Three Along, which was Spin and all of them. I went out there on the whim to see if anybody would like our stuff from outside of here. And I got a response within 5 days while I was out there. Come back and I came back. Gave me the dime tour. I met David Geffen. What's my man name with Rowdy Records? Dallas Austin.
Okay, oh yeah, Dallas Austin, yeah. TLC.
Yeah,
I met
a lot of people. That's how I was able to get my calling card out. He's a songwriter. I can't write some songs. They had listened.
Yeah.
They weren't trying to give me no deal. They had listened. Shaka Zulu.
Oh yeah, Shaka Zulu. That's Lula.
Yeah, Lula. Lula is disturbing the peace. CT. I went over there to try to do some writing. You know, just submit my stuff. Not try to get a deal. This is what I'm doing.
Yeah.
This is what I'm doing. I'm working for hire. I don't need no lawyer. I know my points. I know my publishing. I know my
points in publishing. You know, if you don't know nothing about that, you're an artist. Research. Google it.
My publishing. BDS, then I'm good. So don't try to play. I don't need a lawyer here to tell you I want 1500 standard up front. And
sitting for right there.
I know my game. So I went everywhere. Stankonia, everywhere. I was up there. Lil John, everywhere. Right off of Holmes and not Donnelly Hollywood, Holmes and top of 75 Studio Row. You can cross the street and use somebody else's studio, CTE, wherever.
So
you know what I'm saying, but working.
So you definitely a very blessed career. So let's talk about you had to fall back for 10 months.
I did.
Let's talk about that. And talk about the struggle, man. What was the struggle that you went through and what caused you? Because, I mean, we all sometimes, I like to call it the Dr. Dre aftermath moment, when you got to just step back and like, hey, I gotta rebuild. Can you give us a little?
I can. I was promoting and I was doing hosting. You know, a lot of Cali D. Cali D was the other things. You know, Red Empire, she was trying to artists. I was working with my group.
Okay.
I was helping the other artists that I was working with. It just wasn't going to be a fit.
Okay.
I would come over there and try to be an A&R of an actual promotion company. That doesn't work. I still got contracts in my bag right here. I can show you right now. And it doesn't work. So she didn't honor that. I can honestly say she didn't honor the contract. That, not saying that she didn't do it deliberately, but I'm saying she knew that we couldn't do that. So the contract's null and void. She said, okay, that's fine. We don't have to.
Okay. You know, so it was amicable. Everybody, it was amicable. It's not going to work. It's not going to be a fit. Cool.
You know,
okay.
Business is business. Exactly. I'm not here to, you know, that happened 10 months ago. So I can be a realist and say that, you know, a lot of stuff I didn't understand, you know, at the time. I fell out with a lot of people. I fell out with Snoopy. Hey, Snoopy. You know what I'm saying? I seen him in Terrence Business Spies, and I was about to straight go lose Derrick on this book.
Okay.
And straight like we was in the pod and beat the shit out of him had it not been straight. Literally, seriously speaking. You know, even since then, you know, my ways have been parted from Jay. A lot of people, I have to let them be them, and they have been out here on their grind doing exactly what they do. I'm not knocking anyone.
But the thing is, with business, sometimes you do have to fall back, and it's like, you know, you got forks in the road, and you know, business is business,
man. My path was always the same, though, bro. I never forgot my mission statement.
But you know how it is with certain things. You meet a person, okay, boom, we at this level, but now we got to go. But at least you guys understood, like, this ain't going to work out. So, and then
it
when
was
you,
a lot, bro. It was a lot of bullshit. It was a lot of bullshit. It was a lot of high points. Don't get it twisted. It was a lot of high points to what these cats really got to see. And they were very appreciative. I'm not going to sit up here and say they wasn't. But I knew that it was time for me to leave all this shit alone because a lot of people were expecting shit that I was not ready to do. And I hadn't even done those things myself.
Okay.
Understand what I'm saying? So I'm not the golden ticket. I'm just the guy that you asked to be on the stage. I would split my sets. If I had a 20-minute set, I know that I could split it up and do two songs in 5 minutes and let y'all do whatever it is y'all want to do.
Yeah.
So other people can see y'all. I even did it with Dez before not. Just so he can see that your comfort zone is your comfort zone. You can only be so comfortable so long.
Oh, yeah, you got to step out your comfort zone.
Don't expect people to gravitate to you if you don't go out there and go see who they are.
But I tell people this, too, and one thing that I found out, actually, one of my mentors and my business partners, goes by the name of Gary Devine, MBE Records, and I mean through this guy, because there was a point I had to fall back. After I became a father, I stepped away from the mic for like 5 years, and that's because I was at a point, I was in New England, man, I'm up here charting with Ludacris, I'm up here, we're talking about going on Warped Tour, you know, I'm talking Cold Crush Brothers wanted to sign me in a collective, you know what I mean, Wu-Tang and endorsed us, and the thing is that... I was about to become a father, and it's like, look, I got to fall back because I'm going to become a father. People didn't appreciate that. And I had so many people in my ear that I lost who the hell I was, dude. I didn't trust nobody.
That did not happen to me, but what did happen to me is that a lot of cats hate the fact that I just fell off and didn't say shit. Didn't say anything. They didn't, you know, I was okay to help you. I was all right doing this, that, and the third. I was all right if I promoted and pushed your shit or gave people your CD, even if your ass wasn't present. I was all right to do all of these things, even by not you even asking me to do them. It's in my nature to do it.
Yeah.
You don't have to ask me to help you do a damn thing when I feel like I didn't talk to you long enough to know that I need to show you something else so you can be encouraged to do your shit. So, me doing all of this shit, you still don't get it. So you know what I have to do? I have to leave your ass on Gullah Gullah Island and let you do whatever the fuck it is that you do.
Yeah.
And let you figure out and do what it is that you do. You have to remember something. Anybody out there in radio land, especially out here in Dallas-Fort Worth, I never asked anybody to jump their asses on stage with me. I never asked anybody to come on stage and just help me be who I am. Anybody that came on stage with me, if I asked you to do that, I wanted other people to see you, and I was willingly and very happy to give you my spot or give you share time with you on stage. What you have to remember is this. I was making myself before then. Y'all were supposed to be making y'allself. This is another reason why I had to fall back and regroup with my business and let it be known that this was the mission statement all along.
Yeah. And
all along.
And the thing is, like, you can't, don't expect, I mean, Quincy Jones said this, I love this. If you don't get the goosebumps about what you do, how you expect anybody else to get the goosebumps? And I always, in this journey, I've known that it was always me. And I always tell my boy Gary, like, we sit back and talk. It's like, you know what? Ultimately, it was always us that got us to that next level. So, yeah, crowd.
No, you good.
But, okay. Sorry about that. We had some people in the thing. So,
no problem.
So, now that you've been through that, you back with some hard hit music, so you took some time to just marinate, regroup. So what can we expect in the future, man? What future projects you got going on? where can people in Radio Land get the latest, newest, great, the latest and greatest? Like, what's now, what's the current, and what's in the future?
The current right now is Strike the Crimes Project. That's the story of my life. That's the internet. Everything and some of the stuff that y'all been hearing right now.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? Everything that people that know me, come to know me, my story, my struggle, this is what it is. It's all colorful. It's not some dark, gray shit that when you just hear it, you just saw, oh my God, this struggle is so real. No, bro. It's everything you know what hip-hop was to be. It's the storytelling, the beats, it's the rhymes, it's the truth. You know, I don't want to give y'all some fabricated story of who Louis Gray is. For those of y'all that know me, y'all know what I've been through in the past year and a half, 2 years. Y'all literally know what I've been through. Out of the hospital. And in my car. Taking care of my daughter. On what I need to do. Had no job and still was making. Still doing whatever it is I need to do. And run back home to no parents or anything. If you knew what I was dealing with while I was still hosting these shows and doing what I was doing and encouraging other cats and doing all this, I was homeless while I was doing all of this shit.
Wow.
A lot of people didn't know that shit. And then the cats that did know it, they reached out. Jay reached out. Bub reached out. Darren reached out. All of these people, that was my familiar at the time. We was just out here doing whatever. They reached out, but I had to learn a lot.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I come from a lot of shit, but a lot of people didn't know this because I didn't need to take that with me while I was trying to do what I do, still believe in what I do, still take care of my daughter, still try to help encourage these guys that were kind of dependent on me to show them some other thing.
Yeah.
It was hard. It was really, really hard. But it, testimony came out of all of that. While I had my hiatus, all I was doing was like,
That's all I've been doing,
producing with Hub, or Hub would give me specific heat that he knew that when he gave it to me, man, look, I ain't do this for nobody. You need to really hear this scenario.
Yeah.
I get it and instantly I knew, oh, I got something for that. All I do is write the story. If there's a certain song, I'm going to set it to the track.
Yeah.
That's it. So this hiatus was good for me. It was good for me to fall back. I'm still respected on Underground. It's the third week I've been back on Facebook.
No, I've seen the reception. It's like people are like, hey, welcome back, man.
I posted a picture of he's the best he's ever been. That's a G.
Man, thank you. Man, I so appreciate that, brother. I'm humbled by it all. I am not the best in the world. I said it in a song. I'm not the best at it. I'm just doing Louis.
Hey, that's all you can do. You keep it authentic. So, damn, I'm going to stand a little bit. How do you feel? This is a sidebar question. And I love watching The Breakfast Club and some of the stuff they say. Charlamagne is my dude.
Charlamagne's a damn fool, ain't he?
Okay, let's Elder Statesman. When I say Elder Statesman, 40 plus years old, engaging in rap beats.
That is the dumbest shit. If you need to do that shit to boost your sales, then I really think you need to go your ass back to drawing board, man, because honestly, bro, this beef ain't even authentic. Not that shit with me, all of this, that's not authentic, man, and they forgetting the key elements. Where's the fucking music?
Exactly.
Give me the music.
But now with the Instagram, they take it to a whole, well, social media, they take it to a
even,
whole.
You know what? If they decide to even get caught up in that shit, TMZ and all the rest of this other bullshit, then that's on them. If you want to be shown in that light for that reason, and that's the wrong reason you in for the music.
Exactly.
Me personally, I just told Darren Tech Force this shit the other day. It has to be the music that make you want to come and see me in the first fucking place.
Yeah.
If that has to be paramount. What do you do while I'm an MC? What does your shit sound like? Sounds like this. Everything. I'm saying it's fine, man. I'll get back to you. Get back with me or however you want to do it.
Yeah.
If it's not something you like, then guess what? I know at least five other people.
But I think now with music, it's I think people are more known now
to do rapping.
Personality versus music. You're not just a personality. You're not the music. Like it's all. Cause hey, let's think about it. 2001, or early 50 Cent, that brother came out swinging.
He did, but you know what? Controversy sell records if you're doing it the way he did. I'm the rapper. I get shot.
Exactly, and that's what that's where
so
I was getting.
You have Jimmy Iovine do this. Well, let's go ahead. Let's go ahead and capitalize on that. Now, you know, the back end smur of shit that they do.
But before that engine though, How to Rob. And then
How to Rob was this shit.
Yeah.
But I didn't even know. I knew he was a cat coming out. That was his first single deal, and they stiffed him like son bitch. Mm. But what a lot of people don't know, even for him, because he had the best tutor, Jam Master Jay.
Yep.
You watched the movie. That's the dude that they shot in the chest in the studio. The dude that was sitting there in the studio when those German or whatever those white dudes that was coming, they was
get
looking
rich
for
die trying.
Yeah, get rich or die trying.
Oh,
when he was in the studio and he pushed him back in that rolling chair and then he shot him in his chest in that studio. That was Jam Master Jay. Big head of Izzy. No, he didn't have him. Yeah, they came in that studio looking for
Izzy. Because remember he was talking about that one guy. And to get back at him when he was in the... Okay, I see what you're saying. I got you. Yeah, I see what you're saying.
That's when old boy had the little bright dude in the studio rapping. And then they all came
in
the studio.
Yeah, yeah. Yep.
And he was shooting them chicks. Then he shot another dude. Then he got behind the microphone and said, hey, tell little boy we looking for him.
Yep.
And then he pushed Jam Master Jay back and he shot him. It was like 3-4 times.
Yeah.
Killed that man. And you know what? I'm going to be honest with you, bro. I don't care if it is or whomever, you dig up my whole background and my past, whatever makes you float your boat. But I guarantee you, I'll scorch you on just songs alone. I know how to write songs, bro, and stay away from that beat bullshit.
Yeah.
That is what keeps some of you cats relevant. Where's the music? Give me the music.
And the thing is, too, that kind of, you know, we're musicians. I mean, I've always felt that, you know, God gives you a talent for a reason. You got to nurture that talent. And we're a voice. We're a voice for people that can't speak. And right now, there's so much going on in the world. Like, my favorite artist is, man, Marvin Gaye will always be. What's going on and all during the times, like, I feel like the greatest music was music during conflict when artists came together. Like, the music during the 60s and doing all that whole stuff. Classic music still relevant because it spoke to a time, but nobody's speaking on what's going on now. Like, you got a voice,
bro,
and you like, let's nurture, let's build.
You know why? You know why? I'm gonna tell you why, even if you know. And all of y'all listening, when you make it to the height of heights in your career, you just don't find those letters like that. And some of these cats out here, they'll give you the massage or the facade. They give you the facade, the mask. You know, Wyclef Jean said that shit many years ago. Everybody want to wear a mask. So you take that motherfucker off and you actually see what these people are. Money is pretty much a lot of people's God.
So when
you see these people in certain places, in certain heights, in certain whatever, you already know what that is. Then you see the true artists.
But then when you think about it too, if you know the music business, and you know how it works with the money, how it gets split up. Mm-hmm. All these new rappers, or all these 360 deal rappers, or these current rappers with the streaming, rapping about all this stuff you got, they got. If you know the music business, you might get paid on that second album. You know what I mean?
I'm going to tell you right now, bro. It won't be lasting pretty much long. You know, the world is crazy right now, bro. So these people are already speaking.
So I hate to cut it off, but we gonna have a part two.
Word.
We gonna have Lewis Gray back in here dropping some jewels for you. But listeners, I'm sorry we gotta cut it off. We went over, we got deeper than deep. Lewis Gray.
Thank y'all for having me, man. I really
deeper than music. Me, part two coming soon. And peace out.
One love. Yo, I couldn't wait. Y'all talking about doing a part two.
Man, we didn't.
I gotta deal with y'all.
We talked fucking more than an hour and a half, 3 hours.
Hey, man. Hey.